Nome, it's very naughty, lots of nudity, and lots of blood. Here's the Blood Gnome drinking game. It's set in the BDSM community, so extra naughtiness for that, extra naughty points. And they say the phrase, you know, BDSM, about 20-some-odd times in the movie? What you do is you line up your favorite, you know, booze shots, and when you hear, you watch or rent or buy Blood Gnome, and when you hear the BDSM term come up, you have to take a drink. If you win the Blood Gnome drinking game, John and I show up at your house with duct tape and a ball gag.
Do you like something really violent and bloody? What illusion are you going to do?
I'm going to eat some razor blades in a minute.
Oh, that's pretty good.
You haven't seen this yet, have you?
Hey, no, I've not seen you eat razor blades. I've seen you jam needles through women's throats and drink their blood on stage.
I've done a lot of that, haven't
I? And I produced you at the Limelight, and you set a girl on stage.
On fire.
And that illusion was called...
Burn a bitch.
Gentlemen, get your weenies on a stick, because we're going to burn a bitch.
That's right. We're going to burn her. We're going to burn it good. That's funny, because I'm masturbating, too, and my hands are up on the table. How cool is that?
All right, kids, you ready for a little dark, sticky vampire fun?
That was amazing. That was really, really good.
Did you like that?
I was sitting here, I'm sweating for you.
Who am I talking?
You were bleeding, huh?
Oh, yes. Yeah, it's dangerous. It's amazingly, stupidly dangerous. It's like the way I usually introduce that in my stage show is, don't try this at home unless you're really drunk. You're a bit of a vampire then, aren't you?
A little bit.
A little bit? Yes, do we drink blood?
Only my own.
Only your own. Don't try them at home. But please, do not try that at home. But they are delicious.
I just did.
You just did?
I just did. You made them look so delicious. That I just thought.
And how were yours? So please don't try that. And please, whatever you do, don't tell anyone that I made you try it, because, you know, that would be bad. What's your name?
Zelda.
Zelda?
Yeah.
The Zelda?
Zelda.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing, the talented Zelda. Madam Zelda.
I had to take out my ball gag so I could call you.
I don't indulge in the sun, as you can see. The last time I went to the beach was with you, and it was at night, and that was awesome. On the beach and during the day or stepping into a church, I'm pretty much bursting into flames. Am I not? And I'm sure that's you too,
well,
by the way.
You're bursting into flames most of the time.
Holy water does it. Sometimes Gatorade does it. You know, if it's been blessed, the Gatorade will do the same thing. Yeah. You should tell everybody that I'm cutting you up in Blood Gnome. If you want to see Madam Zelda, she's in that scene with me. She's the lovely, lovely, lovely young woman I am torturing as she's tied to a post. How's that?
Hi.
Hi.
Ladies and gentlemen, Angel, give her a nice round of applause.
I was calling to see if you and Angel could do a scene from a gothic soap opera.
Can I nibble on your neck, I think is what he's saying.
No, can you just give me a little, some sort of orgasmic squeal when I go for your neck? Do you want to be bitten by a vampire?
Yeah.
Are you willing to give your throat to the wolf?
To the
vampire. It's an expression, damn it.
Ah!
I'm going to bite you on the neck and make you one of the undead.
Sorry, all circuits are busy now. Will you please try your call again later?